Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with each of you. And we take a moment of silence and we prepare our spirits for Eucharist this Sunday morning.
Lord Jesus, justify the humble. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, rescue us from evil. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, bring us to your heavenly kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sin, and one day bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
And together we praise our God and pray, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you have commanded, so that we may merit what you promise, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I'd like to call our children and facilitators to come forward at this time. You really receive this word of God, take it with you, proclaim it, and share it with these young lives. Help them to become comfortable and confident. We belong to a God who loves us in all things. Into your hands today is entrusted a mighty work. Go with the peace of Christ.
Thank you. the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. At my first offense, no one appeared on my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from ever evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and the one who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus spoke to those who were convinced that they were justified in their own actions and despised the others. We don't have to go far to see how relevant that scripture is in our own daily life. You know, how we can get so justified as being right and how everybody else can be wrong. We have marriages, elaborate wedding days, and all of the preparation lasts longer than the actual marriage does. You know, we have only to turn on the TV and open our mailboxes to get all kinds of information where people are so self-righteous and so justified in their own actions and yet condemn the others. It's a thing that was just not to the Pharisees and the tax collector, but it's a teaching of Jesus for all of us that when we continually build ourselves up, you know, and think that what we're doing is the right thing and what everybody else is doing is not, you know, that we ease God out of our lives. And we just don't have that opportunity to know God's goodness and that it's all gift. I'm not saying that some of us haven't done wonderful things and worked hard and achieved an awful lot of things, but when we think that it's all because of us, we're just on the wrong track. Because from the very beginning, it's been gift, the gift of life, the gift of our talents, and the way that God has been able to give us the opportunity to use those talents and to put those talents into use for ourselves and for those that we love. The challenge was, in Jesus' time, was that this Pharisee looked like a lot of us. You know, he was the one that was at church, and he was the one that was keeping the law, but he was also the one that was constantly challenging Jesus and also the one that eventually put him to death. You know what I mean? Because the outside did not match the inside. What we perceived as being in society was not what was really in our hearts. It was not what was really in our spirits. And so that's what the challenge of the scripture is for all of us this weekend, is to see that the inside matches the outside. To see that we know that it's the God of all creation that has called each one of us into being and given us the opportunity, and that we have a responsibility to somehow express our gratefulness and our gratitude for those gifts and those blessings. The tax collector was like our criminals, you know. He was the one that was always cheating and always the one trying to, you know, pad his own pocket, you know. But he was the one that knew it was also bigger than him. He knew it was wrong. You know, when we live in self-righteousness, we don't always have that consciousness that we sometimes can be wrong. And that we still have a way in which we can change and develop and find ourselves becoming bigger containers of God's love and God's mercy. These scriptures are read all over the world today. You know, the whole world is hearing the scriptures today. But it's really important for us here at St. Joseph's because this is our commitment Sunday for our reaffirming and our being faithful and grateful for St. Joseph's Parish. And these attitudes of whether or not we think that we have always done everything that we can do and everything that's right and everybody else is at fault, or if we are able to be honest enough to say, yeah, maybe I can rethink how I can be a person that expresses my gratitude and my love and my appreciation for God's goodness and God's mercy and to the goodness of this community, the place where I come and I get that opportunity to touch the divine and to be filled with grace, as I said last week, to leave the chaos of the world and to come here and to have the privilege of knowing, God is here. God is with us. And God continues to help all of us who are on that journey. What we've done this weekend is that at each of the Masses, we've had different parishioners to get up and to speak and to share with us how this parish affects them and what it means to them and what this parish has been for them, just to give us a broader picture of the diversity and the goodness that God brings together in this community of St. Joseph's. At this liturgy, we have Martin Arrington and Mallory Hogue, an engaged couple, who are going to get up and share with us their appreciation and their history and life here at St. Joseph's.
Good morning. My name is Marty Arrington, like Father Tony said. And this is my fiance, Mallory Hogue. We are excited to share with you that in a little over 2 months, we will be walking up this aisle to celebrate our marriage. When Mallory and I were asked to give this witness talk, we asked ourselves two questions. The first, what does faith mean to us personally? And second, what does this parish mean to us? I have been raised Catholic, and I attended school here at St. Joe's, as well as high school with Bishop Mack. As a young child, my faith was shaken due to the tragic and sudden loss of my older brother. Not fully understanding how God could let this happen to my family, I went through years of just going through the motions. I was angry and felt that my faith was lost. Slowly over the years, my faith has been restored. A major turning point was the birth of my son, Eli. This new life changed my outlook on faith. Becoming a dad at a young age helped me put my trust back in the God I had once lost faith in. It was important to me that I raise Eli to know God and to share his love with others. I remember being nervous to come back to church after a long time away, but was greeted with smiles and felt welcome. Looking back at the different struggles I went through growing up, I know now God was present and working in my life, even when I didn't see or feel him. I have chosen to send my son to Bishop McNamara Bradley campus because it is important to me that he learns in a faith-based environment. As a family, we attend church on Sundays, but Eli, he also has the opportunity to attend Mass on Wednesdays, pray before his meals, and have religion classes daily. These daily activities are in addition to what I try to teach him at home. Last year, Mallory and I attended the sacraments talks offered by the parish during the season of Lent. Each week, we heard from a different parishioner on what each sacrament meant to them. I know Mallory and I have gained a lot of knowledge in those few weeks, and we encourage you participate if the parish hosts something like this again. Mallory and I have also taken the opportunity to attend Adoration, which is offered on Tuesdays. After we leave, I always feel a sense of calm and a closer connection with God. I'm excited to begin a new path with my family and am thankful for all that St. Joe provides and the opportunities for continued growth in my faith and the faith lives of my family.
Good morning. As Marty said in preparing to speak with you, we looked at what our faith means to us and what this parish means to us. I too was raised cradle Catholic and attended Catholic schools since preschool. My family moved to Bourbonnais when I was 15. To help me get involved in my new hometown, some of my friends at Bishop Mack encouraged me to attend youth group at St. Joe's. I loved my high school youth group. I built wonderful friendships while volunteering locally by the Rake and Run, Harvest Sunday, and Undie Sunday. I also participated in a few mission trips and YLC. Just a little side note, if you have a high school or a junior high or are those ages, I would really encourage you guys to jump in and get involved. The mission trips were a blast. I loved every minute, from the car rides to the actual mission work. I remember on one mission trip, I was able to help transform a house into something beautiful. Every night, on the bus back to campus, I remember feeling tired and achy, but loved hearing the stories and learning from the homeowners, who were so gracious to my group. These mission trips were a beginning to a pull I had towards missions, where I eventually went to Guatemala to aid a feeding center. I have been a teen attendant and an adult leader for YLC, which is a Catholic, fun-filled weekend up in Romeoville. We dance and sing and learn a ton about Jesus, and I've always left feeling revived. All of these activities, which I have participated in through St. Joe's, have helped me to learn that there is a bigger world out there than just my world. I like to relate everything to health and nutrition, because this is what I majored in college, so stay with me for a minute. Our bodies are going to run for a while on what we do with it. If I start eating healthy, my body's going to be able to fight against infections, it's going to heal quicker, I'll have more resistance, and I'll have more energy to continue going. And then if I add a little workout, my body becomes even stronger. St. Joe's is my basic body. I come to church learning how to fight against selfishness, I heal quicker from those who hurt me, and I have more resistance to keep seeking my faith. Then, just like a workout, I add a couple ministries I feel most passionate about, like youth ministry, adoration, Harvest Sunday, the sacraments talk, or volunteering for RE. And before I know it, I have a great start to my faith body. I think what I'm most grateful for at St. Joe's is you. I might not know all of your names, but I'm pretty good with faces, and I've come to learn to recognize many of you along the 10 years here that I have been a parishioner. I'm thankful you keep coming back because it always encourages me to keep seeking. St. Joe's offers so many wonderful ministries. Find something you're passionate about and share it with us. As Marty said, we will be getting married in a little over 2 months from now. Well, I say that's 75 days, 14 hours, 28 minutes, and 18 seconds. We are so excited to begin this new life as husband and wife, and even more excited to share in this special time with our parish family. Marty and I are so grateful for all the ministries and opportunities St. Joe's has, and that we can continue to grow ourselves and also to teach our son Eli how to continually seek God. Thank you so much for taking a couple minutes to listen to our witness.
Thank you, Mallory and Martin. In the pews, in the racks, there's some commitment cards if you forgot the one that was mailed to you at your home. And we're going to take some time and to fill these out. I mean, obviously these cards are on the financial side, and as the letter said, we need financial assistance so that we can continue to provide ministries and the different things that happen here. But if that's not your case right now, if you're not able to do things, something financially, I ask that you find something that you can do. Something that you can do so that you can be a nourisher of this community and not just a consumer. Something that you can do that can continue to build up the vitality and the strength of this community. Maybe it's just picking up the pews after you leave. Maybe it's coming and cleaning the cobwebs off of the windows during the week. Maybe it's walking through the campus and picking up stuff off the lawn. Maybe it's stopping Wednesday and seeing that the bathroom is clean. There's all kinds of ways in which we can continue to nourish and continue to take care of this community, which is the body of Christ. which is where God has called us to be, to understand His grace, to understand His love, and to come and see, yeah, God has called us into being and really given us all that we really need. We're going to take some time here now. There'll be some background music and fill these out. And if you've already sealed your envelope and you want to say, I'll pray for the parish, or I'll do this, or I'll help with religious ed, or I'll help with the school, or I'll be with youth ministry, whatever the case might be, to write that down. And then when you're finished, to bring it up and to offer it here in this basket. Our way of saying, yeah, we haven't done it all yet. There's still more in every one of our lives. And we are faithful and grateful at St. Joe. If anyone has a card and it's difficult for you to come forward for one reason or another, if you hold it up, hospitality will bring it up for you. Let us stand and place our prayer before our loving God. Let us turn to God in humility, for the Lord hears the cry of the oppressed.
That the church will always rely on God's mercy and goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of all nations will show compassion for the most vulnerable among us, including the handicapped, elderly, and children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all all who are sick in our community are prayed for and help in practical ways. We pray, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And single mothers and fathers who take care of their children find their way to healthy and successful lives in Jesus. We pray, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the success of the faithful and grateful of St. Joe's may allow us to continue our share, our gifts with each other, and provide the resources to serve those others. We pray, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will be remembered here on earth and exalted in their heavenly glory, especially Lawrence Mulligan, Sam Provost, Susie Hollywood, Frank and Teresa Maines, and John and Teresa Hudak. We pray, good Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of the poor and humble, help us see you in the faces of all your sons and daughters, through the example of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered far by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity and made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifested as your church. And so, in community with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace.
Thank you.
I would invite us all to join in the faithful and grateful prayer that's found on the back of our worship page. Loving God, everything we have comes from you. With gratitude, we acknowledge what past generations of parishioners have sacrificed to pass on to us. With great anticipation, we pray and prepare for what we can now leave for future generations. Strengthen us, unify us, and give us a generous heart as we joyfully answer the call to be faithful and grateful as St. Joseph. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And I invite the ministers to the sick and the homebound to come forward at this time. We send you from this assembly to bring the bread of life and the word of God to those that are sick and homebound in our parish community. Go to them today with the assurances of our love and prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and healer. And let us collect our prayers. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord is with you, and may all of us be blessed this Sunday, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We are faithful and grateful to you.